We'll start from cockroachlabs.com and hit the Start Instantly button on the top right. That'll take us to this page with options for serverless, dedicated, and self-hosted. We want a free cloud database, though, so we'll choose serverless. Here, we need to sign up for an account. We can choose to use a GitHub account, or we can fill out this quick form. Once we're ready, we'll hit Get Started, check off the CAPTCHA, and then switch over to email so that we can verify the account. We'll hit Verify, and that opens a new tab with all of our serverless options. We could also switch to Dedicated here, but we want a free database, so we'll stick with serverless. Now we've got a few options to choose from. We can choose a cloud provider, and right now we have options for GCP and AWS. We'll stick with Google for now. We can select a region. I'm in the US, so we'll stick with the US option here. We can choose our spend limit. The default is zero, but we could change this to something like $10, and that would set a maximum spending limit of $10 per month. We want a free cluster, though, so we'll keep it at $0. Notice that we don't have to enter a credit card. Finally, we can change the name of our cluster if we want, but I'm just going to stick with the auto-generated one. At this point, we're all set, so we'll click Create Your Free Cluster, wait just a few seconds, and our cluster has been created. So now we've got this window that's giving us all the information we need to connect to the cluster. One thing that's important is that the password is only provided once. So the first thing I'm going to do is just copy this whole string using the copy button and save it somewhere. Now that that is saved, we need to download the CockroachDB client. All we have to do is copy this command, open a terminal window, and actually let's rearrange this a little, then we'll paste the command into the terminal window. As you can see, it downloads very quickly. In my case, it's going to prompt me to enter my password. It's also asking me if I want to overwrite because I actually already have the client installed on this machine. You won't get that question, but I'm just going to say yes, and we're all set with the client. We also need to download the CA certificate, and again, all we need to do is copy this text box and paste it into the terminal window, and we're done. So now we'll copy the command on the bottom, which tells Terminal to launch the CockroachDB SQL shell and includes our connection string so that it connects to our CockroachDB serverless cluster. We'll paste that, and when we run it, we can see that we've launched the SQL shell and connected to our cluster. From here, we can run SQL queries just like you'd expect. So, for example, we can run show databases and see that there are already a few in our cluster, including default DB. Let's get a little data in there so we can link up a quick Hello World app. I'm going to create a table called Messages here in the default DB, and then I'm going to insert a row with the value Hello World. That's all we need for now, so I'll type \q to quit, and now we've quit the SQL shell, and I'm just going to clear the terminal window to keep things nice and neat. To link our database to an application, we need to have an application. So for demo purposes, here's a quick Python Hello World app that you can find in the CockroachDB documentation. If Python is not your thing, we've got lots of other languages to choose from, and we also have some more advanced example apps. But anyway, what this little Python app does is prompt the user for a connection string to a CockroachDB database, and then it'll connect to that database and print the first value in each row, which in this case would just be the Hello World message we just inserted into our messages table. So let's jump back over to Terminal and run that script. We need to input our connection string, and this connection info window also gives us that in an easy copy-paste format. So we paste that into the terminal, and we can see that Hello World is printed. So we've done it. We created a free CockroachDB serverless cluster, created a table, inserted some data, and then connected it to a simple application. Before we go, though, let's take a look at the web interface for CockroachDB Serverless. we can close this connection info window and get a lot of information about our cluster. On this overview page, we can see graphs of how much storage we're using, as well as the request units and SQL statements. On the other pages, we can see details about the SQL users, statements that have been run, active sessions, and transactions. If our app starts getting popular and we decide we want to scale up, we can also add a spend limit right from this page. So for example, we could put $10 and enter our payment info here and be good to go. Remember that with serverless, you only pay for what you actually use. So if we end up using less than $10 of storage and compute each month, we will only be billed for anything that we actually used above the resources that Cockroach Labs gives us for free.